Hello, vital sign. Today I'd like to show you how to find the interior and exterior angles of a regular polygon. First, let's look at the formula to find the sum of the interior angles of a regular polygon, and then the formula to find the measure of individual interior angles in a regular polygon. Now, let's look at how these were derived and how we can use it to solve problems. Regular polygons can be constructed from circles. For example, to construct a regular polygon, you start with a circle and draw n angles of measure 360 over n degrees, marking the points where the angles meet the circle, where n is the number of sides of our polygon. This divides your circle into n equal arcs and gives you n points equally spaced along the circumference of the circle. To construct a regular pentagon, draw 5 angles of measure 72 degrees. You now have 5 equal arcs and 5 points equally spaced along the circumference of the circle. Continuing with our pentagon example, we can connect the points to form a regular pentagon. Notice that we can now split our pentagon into 5 isosceles triangles like this. Also notice that all the triangles are congruent and that their vertex angle, or the angle at the center of the pentagon, measures 72 degrees. We should also accept that a triangle's interior angles sum to 180 degrees as a given. Generalizing this to any regular polygon, it turns out that we can split up any regular n-gon into n isosceles triangles with vertex angles equal to 360 over n degrees. We can now find the interior angles of any regular polygon. We accept that a triangle has an interior angle sum of 180 degrees. Then we can add up the interior angle sum of all triangles in our polygon to get a total measure of 180 times n degrees. Notice that we included in our count the vertex angle of our isosceles triangles, which are not actually part of the interior angle sum of the polygon, as we are only looking for the sum of these angles. Those vertex angles sum to 360 degrees, so by adding up the interior angle sums of all the triangles in our polygon, we overcounted the angle sum by 360 degrees. This is easy enough to fix. We'll just subtract 360 degrees from 180n. That means the interior angle sum of a regular polygon is 180n minus 360 degrees, or 180 times n minus 2. In our pentagon example, this would be 180 times 3, which is 540 degrees. Also, since every angle in a regular polygon is equal by definition, and since there are n angles in an n-sided polygon, the measure of each interior angle is simply the interior angle sum divided by n degrees. For our pentagon example, this would be 180 times 3 divided by 5, or 108 degrees. Now that we know how to find the interior angles of a regular polygon, finding the exterior angles, or the ones in red, becomes much easier. Remember that exterior angles are supplementary to interior angles, meaning that their measures add up to 180 degrees. The sum of the exterior angles of a regular polygon is always 360 degrees. And here's the formula for individual exterior angles, where n is the number of sides. Next, let's look at one way to derive this formula and the fact that the exterior angle sum is always 360 degrees, using what we just learned about interior angles. First, realize that an exterior angle plus an interior angle always equals 180 degrees, as they complete a half circle around a point in a polygon. One way to overestimate the exterior angle sum, then, would be to multiply 180 by the number of exterior angles in an n-gon. This can be represented visually by drawing little half circles around each point in your shape and adding up the degrees of each half circle. Since there are always n points for an n-gon and 180 degrees in a half circle, our overestimate is 180 times n degrees. For our pentagon example, this overestimate would be 900 degrees. Remembering that the sum 180 times n is equal to the sum of the interior angles plus the sum of the exterior angles, we can now just subtract the interior angle sum from 180 times n degrees to get the exterior angle sum, which is now proven to always be 360 degrees. And further, since each exterior angle of a regular polygon is equal in measure, to find the measure of individual exterior angles, We divide 360 degrees by n. We've now derived the formula for individual exterior angles in an n-sided regular polygon. Using this formula for our pentagon example, we find that the exterior angles measure 72 degrees. Finally, let's see how we can apply our knowledge to three actual problems. Find the measure of an exterior angle of a regular nonagon. We'll need the exterior angle formula for this one. Okay, so a nonagon has 9 sides. That means n is 9 in our formula. 360 degrees divided by 9 is 40 degrees. Find the measure of an interior angle of a regular heptagon. For this problem, we'll need the individual interior angle formula. A heptagon has 7 sides, so n equals 7. 180 degrees times 5 sevenths is about 128.57 degrees. Find the interior angle sum of a regular octagon. For this problem, we need the interior angle sum formula. An octagon has 8 sides, so n equals 8. 180 degrees times 6 is 1080 degrees. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.